Hello students, once again I welcome you all my YouTube channel. Today I am here with class 11th Accountancy. Chapter 1, Introduction to Accounting. And in our last lecture we discussed about the branches of accounting, and today we are going to discuss about the new topic, very short and simple topic, objectives of accounting. What is the reason behind accounting? Why are we doing accounting? And many more questions are there. So today we are going to discuss about them. Few points are there already mentioned. So today we have to discuss about them. Okay. Hope you will get all the points. Any confusion and query you can ask me. At last I will give you my WhatsApp number. Okay. So let's start. The first point is here to keep systematic record of the business transaction. We have to keep a systematic record of business transaction, and it is possible with the help of accounting only. Because in our daily routine life, a number of transactions take place in the business. In a month and a year, a lot of transactions are there. So it's not possible for an individual to memorize each and every transaction. There is need to record. There is need to keep them record somewhere for future reference. Okay. तो इन सबको याद रख पाना, मेमोराइज कर पाना पॉसिबल नहीं है, तो फ्यूचर रेफरेंस के लिए कहीं ना कहीं रिकॉर्ड करना बहुत जरूरी है. दैट्स व्हाई वी आर डूइंग द अकाउंटिंग. सेकंड, टू डिटरमाइन प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस. एवरी बिजनेस कंसर्न वांट टू नो अबाउट द प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी ऑफ द बिजनेस. दे आर इंटरेस्टेड इन नोइंग अबाउट द प्रॉफिट और लॉस ऑफ द बिजनेस, वेदर दे आर अर्निंग प्रॉफिट और सफरिंग फ्रॉम लॉस. तो ओनली विद द हेल्प ऑफ सिस्टमैटिक रिकॉर्ड, ओनली विद द हेल्प ऑफ डेटा, वी कैन नो अबाउट, वी कैन डिटरमाइन द प्रॉफिट और लॉस ऑफ द बिजनेस. If data, in the absence of the data, it is not possible to calculate profit or loss. So, second object is here to determine profit and loss. The third is here to determine financial position of the business. If you want to know about the financial position of the business, financial position means the status of assets and liabilities. How many assets are there in a business? How much liabilities are there? If you want to know about all these things, there is need to keep a systematic and complete record. Then only you can determine the financial position of the business. Okay. Fourth point is there to ascertain the progress of the business from year to year. If you want to know about the progress of your business, so there is need to be comparison year to year. कि आपके पास जो डेटा है आप उस ईयर टू ईयर डेटा को क्या करेंगे, कंपैरिजन करेंगे. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस कंपैरिजन यू कैन कंक्लूड, यू कैन फाइंड आउट दैट कि योर बिजनेस इज प्रोग्रेसिंग और नॉट. इफ देर इज अ एब्सेंस ऑफ डेटा, अगर आपके पास डेटा अवेलेबल नहीं है तो यू कांट डू द कंपैरिजन. फॉर कंपैरिजन समथिंग शुड बी देयर, वी वॉन्ट सम बेस देयर. ठीक है, इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ द बेस देर इज नो कंपैरिजन एंड वी कांट डिटरमाइन वेदर वी आर प्रोग्रेसिंग और नॉट. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज योर फिफ्थ पॉइंट, टू प्रोवाइड इन्फॉर्मेशन टू वेरियस पार्टीज. Many users are there, those who are connected with the business, internal users are also there and external users are also there. So there is need to communicate complete information to the users, and complete information can be provided only when we having a complete and systematic data. Then only we can communicate to the users. Okay. So there is need to communicate with the users. So we have to maintain a complete and systematic record. We have to do proper accounting. Then only we can communicate to the parties. So these are the five objectives of the accounting. Hope you will get all the points. Any confusion and query you can ask. Okay, I think that's all for today. Stay at home, stay happy, stay healthy. Bye bye. Have a nice day.